Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be redoing an old video of mine about creating a profile or creating a new custom profile within Salesforce. So I'm going to actually do a little spiel on security for about 30 seconds. So go ahead and speed forward if you want to skip it and just figure out how to create a new custom profile. Now onto security. So security is really important within Salesforce. There's two versions of security. There is object level security and there are record level security. I like to think of this as a library and what you have access to. So object level is that you have access to the specific sections of library, meaning that you have access to see opportunities. You have access to see accounts. I like to think of it as like in Harry Potter, if you have access to the restricted section, that's object level security. You can see the groups. And then there's record level security, which record level security is that you have access to each individual book within that. So if we're talking the restricted section, you have access to see the history of Voldemort's evil doings, that specific book. Whereas if you're thinking about Salesforce, so record or object level gets you to see opportunities, and then record level gets you to see each opportunity. So hopefully that made some sense. Let's go ahead and hop into setup and I'll explain a little more. So object level starts off with your org-wide and then it gets more granular from there. So org-wide is your default, who has access to what or what objects are open and how open are they. And then with each individual thing and setting, it gets more open. You can't necessarily restrict access unless you have a restriction rule. So it goes within object level, it goes org-wide settings. That's your default. You can open up access with profiles and permission sets. Let's go ahead and go in to profiles and create a new custom profile. Okay, so now we can see the list of different profiles that we have. I'm going to create a new profile, and we do need to clone this off of an existing profile. So I'm going to clone this off of the marketing profile. And then have this be marketing manager's profile. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the settings that was on the profile of the marketing. And then we can add or take away specific functionality or remove access before we go ahead and assign this to users. So first thing that we have are the details, just what's going on. Then we have the page layouts. So the page layout assignment dictates what fields you see on each record. So if we go to, let's say cases, we're going to have the marketing case layout. And it'll be specific different things. Or on opportunities, we'll see only the fields that are important for the marketing users to see. Then we have field level security. So field level security is going to be the individual fields that you see on each record, and if you are able to edit them or just see them or not see them at all. If we go to opportunity, we can see all these different fields that we have. We have either read access or edit access. If both of these are gone, then you can't even see it. So let's say the marketing managers currently cannot see the contract. They can't see the delivery or / installation status field. Similarly for the tracking number, they can't see the tracking number of that. This is really good if you have really sensitive information that you don't want to, you don't want them to use or see. I'm going to open up the contract to the marketing managers so then they can see it and edit it. Hit save there. And then let's go back to the profile. So now we checked out field level security. Let's look at what's next is the custom app settings. The apps are these things over here. These are going to be the service, marketing, community, all those things. Those are the apps. So now we can see what the different settings are. Default means that it's going to be the first thing that you log into. Invisible means that you can see it. So currently, we don't have digital experiences enabled for them to see, which could actually be a problem. So I'm going to come up here and edit that. Of course, please flesh this all out with your stakeholders as far as what security settings you want them to see. I'm going to have marketing be the standard because they are the marketing managers who are going to have this. I'm going to allow them to see digital experiences because marketing and experiences are pretty hand in hand. Okay, I'm going to hit save there. And we're back into marketing managers now that we've changed that setting. Let's scroll. Okay, try and look for, okay, we got page layout. All right, so we did a custom app. Let's talk about tabs. So tabs allow us to see the different objects. So if the tab is on, then we can see it. If the tab is hidden, then we cannot see it. If it is default off, then like you can't even work your way around through weird settings. So like, let's say if contact request, the tab was hidden. Well, you couldn't directly go to the tab and see the contact requests. If there was a related list that showed contact requests, then you'd be able to navigate around it. But if it's default off, then you can't even see it. So we would want to, for this marketing profile, go to digital experiences and turn that on. Okay, then we have record type settings. So this just allows us to see the different record types. Record types works hand in hand with profiles, and page layouts. So then you can customize your security experience to show specific data in certain places, as well as show certain fields. Okay, scrolling down, we have administrative features or permissions. This is going to be your random one-off permissions. And if someone can't see something, 9 times out of 10 in my experience, and they're asking for something, it's going to be one of these really weird one-off administrative permissions. So Google's your best friend here when looking at these different things. So like managing public list views, it allows you to edit list views, which is another video we've done recently. Modify all data is that you can edit all the data that is within Salesforce, which is something you want to use very sparingly. Moderating chatter might be something that you want to add to a marketing manager profile. Be sure to, if you're creating this and you are not wanting to get a lot of people asking for random permissions, then be sure to go in through all of this and really look at it as a lens of, does this person really, really need this setting to do their job? There are a lot of random one-off settings here, so just be careful of those. And then we have general user permissions. This is also another one of those administrative permissions that is going to be random one-off stuff, like managing flows, managing cases, transferring the different leads and cases, different things that you might want to hand off as an admin, like transferring leads and cases to maybe a sales manager. You might want to have this, but this is marketing, so we might not want to have that. And then we have standard object permissions. So you have your default object permissions with your org-wide settings or your org-wide defaults, and that is going to be just the baseline. So if everyone can see accounts, the accounts object, then but not edit it, you might want to open up edit access to the marketing manager profile. And again, this is for all objects. Just be cognizant of what the profile and who is going to be using the profile and what their day-to-day job is going to look like within Salesforce. Then we have session settings. So for this profile, we can set specific settings. So they're currently going to be logged out after 2 hours of inactivity, which is, I think that's a pretty generous thing. And then we can set password policies here as well. Finally, we have login hours. So if you want to only have them log in between 8 and 5 every day and they can't work after work, that can be helpful if your company is really cognizant of work-life balance and they want to set that up. That is something that you might want to use. Then we have login IP ranges. This might be you need your users to use a VPN, or if you only want them to work in the office specifically with their IP range, that's how you would set that. You can enable XPath classes, Visual Force pages, external data, credential data, metadata access, all these fun little one-off settings, which I haven't actually had to use too much in this section here. Google is your best friend when it comes to profiles and understanding what each little thing means, especially when it comes to these different accesses here at the bottom, as well as those random one-off general user permissions and administration permissions. Profiles, you're going to have to copy them off of. They are the second line of defense when it comes to object level access, and they open up the different objects and the different permissions within each object. So if we're thinking of our library scenario again, you could open up the opportunities section of the library, but then to edit which books can and cannot come in, or edit the different lines on the book, then you would need edit access. But again, that works in harmony with the record level access to give you access to each book or record within the system. So that is a quick overview of profiles within Salesforce and how to create a new custom profile within Salesforce. I hope that you found this helpful. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them down below. Like, subscribe, check out the courses down below in the description. You can join the email list at salesforceemily.com, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.